his pure love, unconditional love for me for no reason. That is where I started realizing, what am I doing? I was always focused on myself, and now I am seeing somebody who is focused completely on others. He doesn't need anything by himself, but he is dedicated to bring people like me into real life. So I decided my life is to make other people live. I am reborn now. My whole life, old life is completely gone. And I am a newborn baby with a new life, with a powerful living ahead of me. Whole life, I don't know how many years or how many months I lived, it's all wiped out. I don't see anything of the past in me. It, to that extent, even the black patches in my skin and hand and feet, including that, vanished. So I see new skin on me. I see new life in me. Everything is new. So I just reborn into what Swamiji want to form me into. And I am going to live my life for others as part of this universe. For me, Swamiji is the doctor who repaired my body, my spirit, and my soul, and put a new life purpose into me. I came here as a sick person, and Swami was my doctor. He operated and removed all unwanted stuff from my system and put me into a healthy new being.
So he goes to Buddha and he tells, please accept these two plates of gold and diamonds and this plate of flowers. So immediately Buddha tells, drop it. So the king will get shocked and he'll drop the plate of jewelry. And then Buddha will again tell, drop it. So the king will drop the flowers also. And then again Buddha will tell, drop it. So the king will be wondering, why did he tell drop it again? And then he'll ask Buddha, why did you tell me to drop? I have nothing to drop. Then Buddha tells, drop your identity that you are such a great person, you are a king and everything, and live who you are. So what I understand from the story is, when the king was clinging to his identity that he's a king and he was great and just stuck up to that, it didn't expand him. So when you don't cling to any negative identity, and like when you don't cling on to any identity, you will be happy.
Swamiji has told in one satsang that, like, now you are deciding against life when you get powerless and all that, then you have to, like, you need to again decide for life. Like Swamiji gave an example, like when you get powerless, again one soldier gets created for the bad and for a powerlessness. Then when you say, I am Shiva and I cannot get violated, that time one soldier gets created for you. And at least you need to have 10 soldiers, like you are a god powerless, like some 100,000 times. Then you at least need some 50 times or some few times to make the powerlessness go.
What I feel is, any decision in your life which you take comes only out of a context. Like, even if you see, if you feel that, like, normally you just get up in that sleepiness, you just go take your brush and just clean your teeth. So even at that time, you do the action only because of context of, like, maybe that you want your teeth to be more whiter, or you don't want any dirt in your teeth, or you want your breath to smell fresh. Or you can have a context that, I am Mahadeva, so I'm using Kamika Gama, what Shiva himself has given us. So using that and authentically feeling that, for taking care of this body and making, like, myself experience Shivoham, I am brushing my teeth. So any action you do, it has to come out of any context. So I feel the context is higher than decision.
Before coming to Gurukul, see, though I didn't have the context of we need to study for enriching or something like that, I knew only if I'm going to study now. The context which I was given was, only if you study now, you can survive in your future. That is only going to be for your bread. So I thought that was the context from which I started studying. So only after, but that really did not make any sense to me. So I thought, why should we sit and study all the time? Why so many other people are there by playing so many different games? They're able to enrich and they're still living happily. So that was what I was thinking. But then only after I came here, I understood why we need to study. So there's a complete different context for it. So I feel every action you do has some context to it, but you need to align it to the right context. This is what I feel.
Anybody can join. It depends on their time zones. So we are having a separate Western Yuvasangha according to their time zones, and during their holidays they join us. We do it 7 to 8 Indian Standard Time.
And anyone can join, like wherever you are, all you need is good internet decently so that you can hear you. And anyone from any place, you can join.
And you don't have
any
to,
city, you just have to join the call. That's it.
You just have to be watching satsang every day morning and you can join us.
And that too, this is for all the youth, this is exam season. Most of the youth, this is all the exam season, and where all parents and everyone is like, don't touch anything but your books. But Swamiji is very specifically mentioned that we're doing Vakyartha Sadas for ourselves and for him. So the second we heard that, and we all just said, no matter what, we are going to do our Vakyartha Sadas. So every day with our studies, ensuring that we have completed it, we get on to the call. With all this, we have also internalized on the verse or the topic given for the day. And that part of our day becomes the most interesting part, which everyone yearns for. That 1 hour is the most happy 1 hour we can get. So that experience which we get in the Vakyartha Sadas is one of the most edifying experiences, I can say. Like, because we experience all that Swamiji is giving in the Upanishad satsangs, and it's so subtle, and that's the beauty of it.
It is so beautiful in that group energy, like so many new understandings, more subtler understandings it happens, more than when you sit alone and contemplate it. Because when all of us in the same space with the same understanding, when we discuss together, the whole group energy adds together, and it's such a beautiful experience, and we are evolving as such a beautiful sangha. We wait for this 7 to 8 call. It's a very fun discussion that we have of these subtle truths. So because it's a fun discussion, we don't feel it very heavy on us. It easily becomes an understanding and as an experience then and there so many times. So it's a lot of fun to have Vakyartha Sadas. A lot of fun we have. We laugh. We do a lot of things. It's amazing fun. Everybody can join us.
Every day essence of the Vakyartha Sadas, we write a short gist of what we had concluded for that day, and we posted on our Facebook page. And it's so nice to see that there are people all over the world who actually follow it and reciprocate. They even say thank us for putting up these posts, and we also feel happy that we could help people. So it's a beautiful experience. Our Facebook page is available to anyone. The current Facebook page is called Vedic Teen Kids, and we are going to be changing the name to Nityananda Yuva Sangha. Anyone wants to join? Please do join.